I got my weed rolling, start up a fire. Inhale, exhale, time to get high. As I
twist North Korea, shout out to the radio, shout out to Coach Clue, the DJs.
It's the smoke break.
He didn't have to say it like that. He really didn't have to say it like that.
You know
he gets excited when things happen around him. He's getting excited again. My ladies, my listeners, my gentlemen. Listen, one time. Shout out to the sponsor for those sweet leaves.
Mm-hmm.
I have a good friend of the show.
Yeah, buddy.
Legendary.
Very, extremely. Extremely different. Buddy. That's what they say, right? Different. We like different.
I like it's bizarre shit. Bizarre
very
shit.
Very bizarre
shit.
Okay. So now we have Bizarre here. But we'll let him introduce himself because he could talk for himself. We don't have to talk for him. He knows how to speak to these people.
What up, though?
Uh-huh. Don't be cool now.
Everybody do it, man.
Yeah, uh-huh. Don't get cool.
I was over here smoking the first blunt of the day.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
My man, Foulmouth.
Foulmouth in here too now. We ain't gonna ask him why his name is Foulmouth.
Oh,
we can't
man,
be the stupidest
it's a
thing
great
to do.
Story. That's a great story.
Now we gotta hear the story.
Yeah, he just told us it's a
I
story.
I mean, you know.
And by the way, hold on. Foulmouth, Bizarre, if y'all ever get into any, like, slip and falls, you fall off of a building. You know, like, you wash in and you just slip and fall and the brick stand on your head or anything, call your lawyer.
Brick stand on your head?
Yeah, the brick stand. You know the brick stands on your head?
That's nuts.
Call your lawyer. Anyway, Bizarre.
Where's my lawyer?
Call him. Right here. Here's the number. Call him. He's right here. Shout out to Prince. Yeah, he'll pick up too, right away. You can call him right now, on live if you want. He'll answer.
I just might do that.
All right, so while we're talking, you can do it. Trust me, he'll pick up. You ain't gonna get no voicemail, no nothing. Hello?
But you right can't away. Be foul. You can't be foul mouth when you talk to the lawyer.
Okay.
But no, wait, let's hear the story. Foul mouth, talk to me. What is this foul mouth about?
Oh, shit. So we're gonna do this first.
Yeah. Because we'll get to the project in a second. We know that's what we're here for.
Yeah,
it's a new project.
We got it.
Foul mouth ain't never been with us before.
No. Let's talk. I'm going to introduce myself as the producer, because that's what I'm here for today, but...
No.
I've been spitting forever.
We'll do that later.
Okay.
The producer and all that. We need to know the name.
Yeah.
Well, that's what happened.
It's really getting around.
So, coming up as an MC, this cat gave me my name one day. All right. So, we were at his house, and him and a couple of other homies were doing a shit ton of coke. And
that's cocaine, ladies and gentlemen. For anybody who doesn't, it's cocaine.
And he had these girls over there, and he wanted this bitch to go home. Mm-hmm. And I'm a freestyling cat. Back then, that's all I did want to do was freestyle.
Okay.
So he was like, "Come on, man." He's like, "Say something fucking weird to get this girl to go home," because he had some other girl he wanted to come over.
Mm-hmm. If you're watching this, baby girl, this is you. We're talking about. It's you.
So I started saying a bunch of ridiculous shit to her while I was freestyling. I went from like normal to like right, and she wasn't acknowledging me. She was acting.
Well, she was giving you the stiff face.
So I was getting as close as possible. I was giving it to her as good as I possibly could because she wasn't even recognizing me. I didn't even exist during this. I never got not even an initial reaction. She acted like she never seen it going on.
Mm-hmm.
So my boy sees this going on, and he's been doing a ton of coke with him all night.
Cocaine, that is, ladies and gentlemen. Cocaine.
And he took like Jesus piece off the wall at his parents' house. And it was like, he made his fake necklace out of it. And it was
now,
like,
listen, ladies and gentlemen, Jesus, if you're listening to this, I'm listening to him. Man, I have nothing to do with
this. Can I say hell and Jesus? Yeah, what the hell?
It's literally like this long, right? And he's acting like it's a necklace. Like,
but this isn't, it's hey, Jesus?
It's
Jesus,
like
Jesus.
Yes, it's one of the Jesus Christ Jesus himself. Christ.
The Lord. The Lord. Okay.
And so once he seen that these girls weren't going with it, he had his own version of getting their attention. Mm-hmm. And he's real over the top, because he knows who he is. He looked at this girl and he said, "God told me to jack off his kid, so I did." And he started stroking the bottom of it. And he's looking her in the face. He's going,
of Jesus?
Jesus. He goes, uh-oh. He's coming. It's about to happen. And he took out this kitchen, like the lighter, he liked the stove, the big one. And he acted like he like came, and he closed his eyes, and he grabbed the Jesus, and he lit his face on fire. and burned his face in front of these two girls. And they finally caught everybody's attention. And on her way out, she goes, "And you're a foul ass motherfucker," on her way out the door. And my boy come walking out the other room happy as fuck. And he was like, "That's it. You're foul mouth."
Now look, that's ladies and gentlemen. That's him. That's him.
Insane.
Now look what we're gonna do, though.
Ridiculous.
I don't know about you. I'm gonna remove myself from the Jesus part. Me. Because Jesus coming was kind of crazy. What? Listen, to each his own. Everybody's into some different shit. Jeez.
My homie's wild, so when they didn't buy in, he was gonna make sure they did.
Okay, yeah. No, wild that he is. I don't know. Yeah. I don't know if I would have been able to go to sleep that night because the big homie might have been like, "No more waking up."
I was crying because you could see the look of horror in their eyes after they played it off like they weren't scared of shit or didn't see it coming.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, man.
So now we know why he's foul mouth. Now we get it. He fouled the lady.
So the part of the story I leave out is my homie actually had already came up with that name like 2 months prior to that. Mm-hmm. And I wasn't sure if I was going to rock it yet. And then when that girl said that, he came out of the room and said, "Yeah, you're foul mouth." And that's literally what settled the name.
Okay, well, foul mouth, but now you're a producer.
Yeah, I still spit sometimes, but mainly produce.
Mainly produce. Okay.
I rap for fun. Producing's the serious part.
No. So how do you and Bizarre hook up on this project?
On this project?
Yeah.
We've actually been working for a minute, but we got a lot. Well, for this shit, for He Got a Gun.
And that's the name of the project. He Got a Gun. So look what we got going on. Jesus is coming, and He Got a Gun too. So let's go.
So you asked me how we got together and.
How did y'all come up with the, you produce, let's get this project going and let's put this out?
He came up with the idea for it. We were already fucking around to put tracks together. If you listen to Dumpster Juice before we started this shit, mm-hmm. I got a couple of joints on there. He's got other joints that fit that sound that aren't me. Mm-hmm. So once we sat down and started just cooking up, we got about 5 or 6 songs in and it was his idea to do the album. But he came ready with it because he had the name for it and shit. And after that, we just took off.
So sonically, I just connected.
Yes.
Okay, that's always a easy part of the game. So Bizarre, when you heard the production, what made you say now it's time for me to go in and put this together as a project?
Well, shit. Somebody had told me about Foul Mouth. You know what I'm saying? And they took me over to his basement. Cause he don't like to leave the basement.
Hey,
you know what I'm saying?
So, whatever works for him.
Yeah. So actually, that's what made the project come along, man. You know, I was getting sick of hip hop. You know, that shit became such a business that I just lost my love for it. So you know, going over his house and then just like in the basement rapping, he had a lot of young rappers over there and shit. That's all this mad shit going on. He's got a cat, a dog, his girl cooking breakfast upstairs.
Right.
A lot of distractions.
Grindy shit, major, you know what I'm saying? It just gave me that feeling when I was a teenager.
Mm-hmm.
When we was, you know, in the basement coming up.
Right.
So that kind of brought my hunger back.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Then next thing you know, shit, I started coming over every day. We had a whole project together.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? And I had to sharpen my shit up too because, they have my name on a couple of lists for like 30 wackest rappers ever.
That's so crazy.
So I ain't like that shit. So I had to
step my shit up. That? Who would list is this? What's going on?
I think it was, Gillian Wallow. They had like one of their first shows back. It wasn't, I don't think it was them, but one of their co-hosts.
So you was one of the 30 wackest?
Yeah, they had Silk the Shock in front of me, man.
Ooh.
That's crazy.
Well, you know, and his attention though, anyway, right? So
my thing is, why did you start losing the love? Like, you didn't say lose the love, but why did you want to give up? What was?
No, I didn't want to give up. It's just that, you know, it just became a business. So what I'm saying is, like, I was doing a lot of half-assing it. You know what I'm saying? Like the love. You know, it just became a job.
Yeah,
go here and do this verse for somebody.
The music business.
Yeah,
absolutely.
But, like, this dude right here is so pure and the purest form. Like, he don't give a fuck about nothing but making beats, you know what I'm saying? And
I mean, he loves the music. Like anything else is sad, but it's what you have to do is you have to know your music business as well.
Yeah.
Because you can love it and you can love it as well, but once it starts to get out there to them, they don't give a fuck about that love. Yeah. They're going to try to squeeze every dollar out of you. Every dollar.
Yeah.
And you being who you are, you already know that because you've been through the mill back and forth. So. But doing it organically like this, trust me, if it just stays y'all too and y'all out, because y'all control everything, it's y'all's.
Yeah.
So if y'all sell it at the pace that y'all want to do it and y'all do what y'all want to do at 100%.
Yeah.
Is it a little tougher? Sure. Can it be done? 1,000,000%. Yeah. So it's just sticking to it and not having somebody feed your ear or feed his ear. Yo, you could be getting more. You could be doing more. And vice versa. It happens all the time.
That's right.
Once you slap that out your ear, you good. You just got to stay, you know, and whatever issues, two people could discuss it.
Yeah. Like our relationship was old school. It was like, you know, I come over his crib basically damn near every day.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? We'd sit there, go through some shit. I'd start fucking with some shit. Like, we stop, go to the store, get some bloods, some food, you know, go back, smoke, you know what I'm saying?
Get back in your creative space.
Yeah, you know, the young rappers that come over there, because he know a lot of rappers.
Right.
The young underground, you know what I'm saying? So they like, oh, the OG over here. And then that's how I start having it, too. Like, I'm getting on each song with these young niggas. I'm like, I ain't about to let these young niggas just spank me around.
Right. Gotta be a spar of that shit.
Yeah, so that's... That,
that's how them young niggas be spanking you.
Is it? That's crazy.
That was crazy.
It's never happened.
That's crazy.
Have you ever been spanked by
young dudes out here spanking me?
I'm asking you a question.
That's crazy. You know how that sounds?
I'm just asking you a question.
No, hell no. That's crazy. What are we talking about?
I'm asking a question. Why can't I ask the question?
That's one. Wow. That's one. That's one. Watch. There's more to the show. That's one.
There you go. You go, good light.
Okay. All right.
Just know that I'm gonna know that you have it. So if you put it in your pocket,
okay.
Don't worry about it. He's gonna blame me anyway.
Oh, that is true.
Oh, where's my lighter?
He usually steals it. That's you see the guilty conscience, how they speak.
Yeah, man.
So, yeah, the young boys.
So, yeah, man, it came out crazy, man. We got a crazy response for the first one.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? And then, like, you know, we just kind of, like, we seen it kind of united our city, too, as far as, like, the underground hip-hop shit.
Mm-hmm.
Because he plugged to the underground. And they looking at him like, damn, man, you got Bizarre to come down to the basement, to the snake pit, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And we just kind of combined the both worlds together now everybody fucking with it, so.
That's a good thing. A lot of people don't even know who Tech N9ne is. He's straight underground, and he's been doing it forever. And you can't find a person more happy in his music business than him.
Yeah.
Because he's like, I do everything myself. I get everything myself. I come out when I want to come out.
Yeah.
I do the push when I want to push. Nobody can tell me go do this or go do that.
Let's just start with another break, man. Mm. We got another story, man.
Well, hold on. We gonna get to that story, too. We got nothing but stories here. Matter of fact, before we go any further, because I told you this earlier.
You looked at me before you did.
No, because I told you this earlier.
This can't be something good.
Hold on. I'm going to ask a question. I need to ask this question.
Go ahead, ask it. I'm listening.
Bizarre. Oh, and Foulmouth. Both of them. It's two of them here, so we could ask.
Oh. Well, his name is Foulmouth. I know he... Come on.
Ladies and gents, I've been doing this for the last... How many shows we got now? 32?
33.
And what's that shit that they say that you got to say?
Like, share, subscribe,
that
guys.
Shit. Yeah, that shit. And here, follow here and go there and all of that. Yeah, now, right. I'm going to ask you, Bizarre, and I'm going to ask you, Fowler. Young ladies in the house with you. Chilling. They kick back, laid back.
Come on, man.
She gets undressed.
I'm not the only one.
Yeah, about to rap.
Right.
And she says, before we get any further, I need you to eat my feet. I need you to suck
hold
my
on. Toe. Stop. Pause. Wait. Time out. First, you're not even presenting it right. You already got them against me.
Eating feet.
No. You're not going to say, hey, wait, let me eat your feet. You sound like Jeffrey Dahmer. That's crazy.
She says to you, you have to lick her toes. That's how you
want okay. It. That sounds better. All right. Eating feet.
Are you
nuts.
Into toes, my good brother?
Yes, I am.
Come on.
You. No. Thank you, my.
Wait a minute, your name is Foulmouth. Come on.
I got two fucked up looking disgusting ass feet.
Mm-hmm.
You're not asking for her to do it back to you.
No, I just, I don't know.
I'm listening.
I've never, I just
yo,
always.
Yo, you don't have to explain, yo. You don't have
that's
to explain.
Yes, he does. Explain yourself, my good brother.
No, forever, that's how I see feet. Right. Like, they're just like some, like, ugly.
Because of yours?
No.
No, just in general. I'm just not in
it. It's just ugly to him. It's just ugly, that's it.
No, he thinks the whole world is his feet.
Yeah. This is what I'm saying. See, that's what I'm saying.
No, because I've always assumed feet were just
nasty.
Yeah, even as a kid when my feet were little kiddy.
So when stink. You see a beautiful woman, you don't look down with the open toe shoes like, yo. You don't look down.
You think about yourself and it's disgusting.
But hey, that's like anything
else. Like when you look at how feet, you see yours.
That's like anything else. I got homies who absolutely have to fuck bitches in the ass. They're like they love this shit. They're in love with that shit.
Wait a minute.
But like,
how the fuck do we go from feet to an ass?
Because people pick.
Not everybody's into some shit now.
Yeah,
but I just need to ask a question. See, you just got. Literally told you have to say why you don't, right?
Yeah, so I don't hate on it.
Why do you do?
Why do I do?
Yeah.
Shit, man, I'm a motherfucking freak, man.
Here at the sad part, let me tell y'all something. Before Bizarre came in here and sat on that couch, me and him was talking behind the scenes. And I said to him, I said, yo, no one has said yes yet. No one. I said, yo, you know who's going to say yes?
Show enough, come on. What's the, I don't understand what the cross color foot fetish.
But that doesn't mean that people like to do it. It's just two people out
of the
right,
he's one of us then.
It can't be just anybody.
Oh, he's this anybody. The, doesn't
come on now. Hold on. What is this? The last show, the couple of shows back. I said her hygiene gotta be good and she gotta be mine. Like she gotta be right, and she gotta be with me. Like I can't just You tried to get me the first night, yo. Take your feet and put them on the couch. Take your socks off. Let me eat your feet. Like that's crazy.
That's what he's into.
Crazy.
That's how he likes this shit.
That's crazy.
Which I want me to tell you.
Whatever.
That's what he's into. Man.
He's got a gun too.
That's what we need to talk about.
There. Yeah.
He got a gun too. So now look, yeah, I got that in similarities. Feet. So now. You got a foot two. He got a foot two. Gun two, foot two. Everything's making sense.
What the hell
now.
Was that?
It just makes sense.
What the hell was gay. That?
It comes lunch.
I promise you.
What the hell?
Got a story on it comes lunch, man.
Now, here what we got to do now, right, ladies and gentlemen? We got the answer. You happy now? Yes. Do you feel good?
Yes.
You finally found another
yes.
person
yes.
that says yes. he sucks toe.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So now you know that it's more than just me and I'm not crazy.
No, I know that it's just you and Bizarre now. So it's two of y'all. That's all. I don't know anything else.
Toes, right?
Yeah. Toes? That's what I'm trying to tell you. What? You? No.
You nobody said yeah else in the room. No, you said yeah first. You seen him?
Nobody else in the room.
He said.
Nobody else in the room. It's just two people. G and Bizarre. That's
yo,
it.
Nah.
It's what? It's five cool. or six
it's
of us
cool.
in here?
It's
come
cool.
on. Six people. It's cool. Two. I take out percentages.
It's cool. We like to stand by.
I'm always do something for it, but I'm always trying to take it to the next level for it. Bitch. I know.
All right, so now when you say that,
she'll
right?
come see me before she see you because I'm that nigga that's willing to go.
Did you go? Please.
Farther
than
you.
Go?
So you hear this
did
shit?
You go? Did you go?
Listen,
did you go? Come on.
Look, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to tell y'all you could do whatever you could put your fucking nose in between her asshole.
Ladies, tell us what y'all
matter.
Think. Do y'all want y'all men to be pleasers? Because that's the title. Pleasers.
I mean, nah.
Pleasers.
Why are we even having this conversation right now? When the hottest shit out right now is a bitch saying, and I'm eating his ass.
Whoa.
Eating his
whoa,
ass.
Whoa.
That's the hottest shit out right now.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh,
hold on. You never heard of Susie? Susie chick, she's the hottest chick out right now.
I know.
She's talking about eating her dude's ass. God. That's the song.
Yeah.
That's what it's about. And all the girls is...
Yeah.
Doing all that shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm convinced.
Nah, but look, here's a good thing. Look, here's a good thing, ladies and gentlemen.
We be eating niggas ass.
I'm 48 years old, so I'm removed from most of this shit. Dear Lord, listen to me. I'm talking to you, Lord. If that's what's going on in today's society, tonight when I go to sleep, just come take me, man. Just tap me on the shoulder and say, come with me, my child. Get me out of here. I'm good. I don't need this shit. Come on. My grandmother got to be up there bugging right now.
I'm convinced, yeah. man. Big what? Shock value. It's nothing but shock
oh, that song? Yeah. He played it for me a couple
shock
weeks ago.
Value. Shock value. That's, how, that's
like,
how a lot of that's how a lot
like,
of these artists are getting.
Like she's gonna get it.
That's how a lot of these artists are getting.
Said, nah, but look, regardless of what we're talking about
ass,
it right now, right?
We switched. Now I'm eating his ass.
See, so we're talking about it, so it works. As far as us talking, they got part of it.
So it got another couple of views.
Absolutely.
Just to find out what it is.
But now, Bizarre, let's talk about this. What are you into? Not in a hole. But give me an artist from Detroit that you checking for that you like. You know what? This young blood got some. I like him. Because you come from a camp that stamped hip-hop. Exactly. Stamped
factual, legendary.
So we can't just forget that part of the game. Like, and your partner is arguably one of the best.
Rest in peace, proof.
So with that, you know what y'all was doing when y'all was coming up. Who you looking behind you like, you know, kid, I like what you got going on. Somebody that Bizarre would stamp. Your stamp.
Oh, shit. Damn.
Pay attention, man. He's thinking. It's got to be at least two of y'all.
Shit, probably my man, Kane Cole.
Okay.
And,
you got any music on?
Yeah, I got some. Yeah, my album, too.
See that? So
then my man, Fat Ray. Uh-huh. Okay. Fat Ray dope, too.
Yeah. And, producer-wise, who would you say right now in Detroit that you like, you know what? He need a beat from me. I could go over there and spice that up real quick and give him something different. Thinking is ill, and thinking is because of the weed, nah. Not because they don't know.
Honestly, you know what?
Your brain is so slow.
I got a joint with them already. I got a joint with them already. But John Connor, if I could, like, that'd be dope. If I heard him on like the type of shit me and him do, that style of beat that I do.
Yeah. Okay.
My man Kane, who he's talking about, Kane Cole, that's the same style of beat. I like. They're the only cats I really make that feel for, the dark, hard shit. They fit it. I don't really do that for anybody else.
Okay.
I would love to hear John, because John Connor's one of them cats. You give him a slow tempo, and he's gonna come regular. Then he's just gonna start double timing. And some cats, when they double time, I get lost. He double times; it's incredible. Like,
so now look,
he'd be a different element to it.
As a producer, when you start doing your whatever you do, whatever you call it, whatever you're into, your sound. Do you do sounds for particular people, or do you do your sound and just be like somebody will
pay attention to it? It's my sound, but it's what that person is. It's my
artist,
version of
it's
them.
The artist, like, and the marriage.
But it's gotta be a marriage. Like you just said, bro. He said that exact same thing. And it's crazy you said that, because I got obsessed with that when I heard him say it. We were talking about a track of one of our homies. It was a track we weren't fucking with. We're like, I don't know about this one. And he was like, yeah, man. He was like, it ain't married.
Yeah.
When he said it, like, I've been obsessed with that since. Like, when I'm listening to tracks, like, all right, are these two for sure? Is there something about this that ain't in the pocket? Or, it's literally been in my head since. Like, every time I do any songs, it's part of my regular process now.
I feel like that's how every great producer thinks.
Well, sometimes you can have a track, though, where you might play for somebody and it don't feel married. But, prime example, first time I've heard Eminem.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, bro, those patterns and shit, I was just, like, confused. I was like, what the fuck just happened? Mm-hmm. Everything was rhyming so good. I didn't really understand it. It took me two or three times, and I truly got what was going on.
I mean, you know, pockets, cadence, a lot of that shit matters. So when doing it, and you know him being an artist, I told you he got his ass kicked by, like, two or three young boys, but he still does what he does.
Oh, for real? They scraped him?
Yeah,
Don't believe this. Don't believe it. Yo, you think you're coming to believe in you. Don't do that. Smoke some more sweetly. I was there, y'all. Come on, get back to your element. You bugging right now. Take your medicine, please. Take your medicine. Yo, yo, you're amnesia, boy. I tell you, shit is different, man.
Yo, you getting old on me, man. You don't remember what he did. Great.
Who's he?
You know what I'm saying? He knows.
This is crazy.
So, did you hear the heat?
All right, so we're gonna put him on blast. Who is it? Look at the camera right there. Say what it. No finger.
I'm gonna at you in a minute, big dog.
Wow.
Anyway.
That's
Bizarre, back to you.
He's slick.
Yeah, you see this?
you and Foul Mouth put this project together. Give me features on it.
Ooh.
No, you know what? Let me put y'all even in a better hot seat, because I like to stir the bullshit.
Right.
What's your favorite
feature? I was gonna ask him that. Yeah.
I like that.
Let's hear this one.
Feature. So that means if you didn't get...
He knows my favorite feature.
We want you to say it. Fuck what he's gonna say.
Oh, no. My man Jay Classic. It's the track... He's seen the vision of the track early, bro. Like, he came over, I played the beat for him, and he's like, oh, this is some, like, back and forth shit.
Right.
And then, like... 10 seconds later, yo, what are you doing, bro? Come through the files. He knew exactly how he was going to do it. Mm. He got through a certain spot. He was like, foul. He's like, flip the beat right here and do one of them. He's like, do a sample flip, no drums. I don't do it that often.
Mm.
And we've been wanting to do the right one because, you know, everybody's doing them.
Okay.
But we just wanted to have the right moment if we were going to do it.
Okay.
And literally, I played a sample earlier and he's like, yo, go back to that sample, put it in there. So, like, he literally laid this track out to his liking from the first two loops.
Well, artists are producers in their own sense, because when they're recording, they're listening to the shit in their head.
They already have
a pattern or a certain pocket or something that they want to hear and sound now, where that person delivers it to you, and then you create
that. Oh, that's perfect. See, I love that shit. Like, some people are closed-minded in that process. Like, some producers, they don't. They will like. They don't want to hear what you got to say about the beat or some shit.
Well, then that's never gonna.
And I get it. You like the beat the way it is, but if you're trying to make magic with somebody, you got to be able to see their vision, and you should be working with somebody where their vision makes sense with you, anyways.
Absolutely. So that's the favorite feature. You did the whole album.
Yeah.
Don't.
Now the favorite song. Your favorite song on the album. And what inspired that favorite record?
Probably the song called Shoot Around. That's one of my favorite songs.
Okay.
It's Piff James from Jersey. Fat Ray. Mm. I just like the sparring of it, you know what I'm saying? The competitive.
So you still in your bizarre mode, like you haven't tried to switch. And again, nothing against the young boys. I love y'all. If it wasn't for y'all, and I don't understand the constant back and forth, young, old. It's all music, bro. Yeah. At the end of the day, if it's good, it's good. And if it's bad, it's bad.
Yeah.
I know a bunch of young motherfuckers whose music is bad. That shit is just terrible. I know a bunch of old motherfuckers whose music is bad. It's just terrible. But don't count everybody and put them in the same bucket, because it's not like that. Yeah. Separate. We need the young. They got to keep this shit going. After a while, you ain't going to want to do this shit no more. You sit there and look at the stage like, huh? Get up there and rock for them. For what? 15, 20 minutes straight? Boy, I can't do that shit no more. So you know you're going to have to pass the baton. But that doesn't mean you can't put a record out or two. Bizarre, talk to me. This story, the second one we got to talk about. The one we cut off that you said we was going to talk about later.
Oh,
let's get into that one.
Come on, man.
Mm-mm.
Here comes lunch.
Here comes lunch.
Oh, man.
There we go.
y'all don't even want to talk about it.
Smoke break, baby.
So it's worse than the...
Yeah, it's bad. I don't know.
Fuck it.
What the hell is going on?
What happened to hip hop?
Uh-oh.
All right, so
we're still gonna talk about hip hop, but we gotta talk about this.
Busy just loves this term, man. So we were like 15. This kid I knew growing up used to have this girl come to my house, and she would like come over and give a bunch of dudes head, right? All the time. I mean, everybody knows those girls when they're kids. This is just a part.
No, this is just a part of life. No, sir. I have no idea what he's speaking of. No, sir. I have no idea.
Those teenage years. But my friend thought it was funny. He wanted to start playing this game to see who could say the funniest thing to her when you came. And this motherfucker literally from my basement went, "Here comes lunch!"
That's not it.
While everybody was upstairs at my house.
Hey, he nutted and she had lunch. What's wrong with that?
We need to get some t-shirts.
It's not a bad gig, yo. You might want to put something together right here. Here comes lunch.
Listen, that's literally like that dark humor shit. That's the and all the kids I grew up with. Those are different people I'm talking about. Yes, you know what I mean? They're all funny.
They're lunchers.
Yeah.
They ain't the lunch.
Fuck it. All right. That was a quick little break.
Now look, wait one second. Shout out to the sponsors, right? Shout out to the sponsors. That's when you know he high. Just keep focus on him. Focus on him. My boy's high.
Quick little break.
That sweet leaves, baby. That sweet leaves works. It works. Damn, God. That's what we like to hear.
Shows. What shows you got coming up?
I mean, this is a promo tour. Besides, when you was at Shady, you said yesterday.
I ain't going to no shows. I'm this high shit.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on. I don't know what you're doing with these joints, but I'm higher than normal.
Cancel the tour and shit. Not performing.
Going home. That sweet leash is a mother.
I tell you, this bitch is something different.
Yo, shout out to the sponsors, baby. Oh, man.
Oh, do realize.
Oh, yeah, damn.
That's Batter's
going.
Box. Look,
it's
coming back.
You looking for a look.
Sweet Leafs, AC, coming soon to the corner of Tennessee and Pacific. It's milk. Yeah. Ayo, fat stacks, big packs, zigzag, game raps, kick back, relax, sweet lease on the map, for the trap, for the block, pull up, come and check the spots, release out of AC, that's your recreation, we shot, we got what you need, anytime, any hour, CBD, THC, vape or the flower, London pound cake, Gary Pate or the sour, we give you the power, or the Insta or the app, we deliver all your goods with a smile and a dap, or kick it in the lounge, you know where the party at, this it, our shit legit, gon' get you lit, so go holla at my homies, the owners, that's Juice and Vic, cause all they but delicious is perfectly priced, terrific. So if you hit Atlanta City, come and take a visit. How the sweet lease on Tennessee and Pacific. How the sweet lease on Tennessee and Pacific.
Well, you got it.
I believe Europe. You. Europe. I'm Europe in October.
Okay, Europe in October.
Canada, yeah. August, I think.
Mm. Yeah, you know you can't, can you get smoke in Canada?
I think so.
No. I don't know. Mm. They have different rules. In
different ways. No, I think Canada already had good rules. They had good rules with weed, like, in the
90s. You can buy, like, dope and crack and coke in one of their states, like, legally.
Yeah.
Whoa. But look it up. There's a place in Canada where you can go and buy meth, crack, dope, everything sold to you right there. You could got a little room where you could take your drugs and everything. I promise you this.
Canada got the free health care going on.
We ain't got that. No, yo, matter of fact, let me ask this question.
Yeah.
Y'all happy with what my man Biden doing so far?
Why the faces? Yo, the whole couch just got down.
That was interesting. I don't think we've had that yet. That's a first.
Yeah. Vote coming up next year. Who y'all voting for?
I'll tell you who I'm not voting for. Anyone.
Me and you on the same plank. Okay. Bizarre.
What is the question?
Here comes lunch.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have no idea what's going on.
Yo.
The weed
is
taking over.
Oh, shit. Yeah, I don't know what you gave us. Oh, what the fuck? I smoke lots of good weed every day, and I'm way higher than normal.
Sweet leaves. Get that baddest box, baby.
Is this right here?
Get that baddest box, baby.
Is that? Oh, and this is the strain. Now, don't forget that.
We're the lunch lady
yet. Don't forget about that.
Oh, man. Maybe we got to find a lunch lady.
Yeah.
They gotta come back when we're gonna have a lunch lady.
Here we go.
Yeah.
We're lunch lady. That'll be a cold for with the bitches that sucking dick.
The lunch lady.
Yo. We're the lunch lady.
And we're taking alien to come up with that, right?
That's it.
Yo, let me ask you. Look, can you do that dumb shit?
He's one of us. What you mean, dumb shit?
Can you do that?
Come on, man. Come on.
With your head.
Come on.
Can't do that.
It's a little stressful on the hand a tiny bit. It's not bad though.
I can do this though. Oh, wait, this is a good one. Now hold on. So you an alien?
Fucking reckless.
Yo, hold on. Do you believe in aliens? How about that question? He's probably gonna say right into one.
So I'm gonna give one quick answer to all that shit, right?
All that shit. Okay.
It's all believable. But until we have true proof, we just can't call it a fact. How about that? So it's
I'm one of them.
He said he's one of them.
I'm one of them.
Well, never mind. I changed my mind.
Here's a factual proof.
He changed his mind.
Here's where you fucked up at. Tell him to do some alien shit then.
No, I don't reveal that to just everybody.
See what I'm saying?
What are we doing here? What are we doing?
Do something. Turn your head around.
You can't do this.
I don't want to.
Oh, okay. Well,
stand on your fucking head.
Oh, so like it's like a Men in Black version of an alien where like you're about to
see. He understands. He believes. He just don't want to tell you.
Yeah. He doesn't even know your name.
Your arm just like turns into like a snake arm, but for some reason it's an alien.
Watch this. What's his name? See that? fucked them up.
It's only because you asked me. If you wouldn't have asked me, I would have been able to say it.
See, they're aliens, but they don't even know each other's name.
Come on. Yo, Bizarre, you believe in aliens?
Look, he's seeing one right now.
Nah, he definitely believes
in aliens. He's in Mars as we speak.
This is what I'm saying, Sweet Leaf.
Mm-hmm. I believe in Sweet Leaf.
Yeah. Ah.
There we go. That's what we're getting.
Fuck it all.
There you go.
We're lighter at, man.
There you go. There we go. Huh. Bang. Yeah. All right. So, music wise, I got what you call it playing later after the this is gonna be the smoke break. Mm-hmm. But I'm gonna play y'all stuff on the Saturday smoke break playlist. Comes on at 8 p.m. That's on radio. So whatever music y'all send me, I'm going to play everything. So just make sure you send what you want played.
Okay.
Don't be upset later and be like, damn, I shouldn't have sent that. Fuck that boy. I don't even care. I don't fuck with whatever you want out there, send it. And I'm going to play.
Gotcha.
All right? And last night, well, actually tonight, I'm playing, what was it playing earlier? That's my shit.
I don't remember.
You was in here bugging.
Hi.
Fuck. That's it. The Bizarre, your
I got it. I got it.
Yeah, that's
it. Oh, okay.
I wish I was here.
Yeah. I love that record. Matter of fact, I'm gonna play
that. I was really high that motherfucker.
And it sounded like it too. That shit sounded like a real organic song.
Right.
Besides this project, is it independent? Is it label? Are you distributing it yourself? Like, what's the?
Man.
Because you're on a promo tour, so I know that means something.
Yeah, we just grinding, man. We're trying to keep it independent, man.
Best way to be.
You know what I'm saying?
But you know, independence, you can go get a bag with somebody. You could just be like, yo, give me this. And
well, fuck it.
Yeah, as always.
We'll give you all our bags.
Hey. Only on a smoke break, baby. You're not going to get this nowhere else.
What the fuck?
Are you perfect? All
right. So now let me ask. Let me this is real easy, too. This will be a good one. I'm gonna go with Foul Mouth first because I know he's cooked. He's still a little bit here. He's cooked. Foul Mouth, you ready?
Yeah. I'm fucking toast.
I've seen his face.
Bro, I smoke a lot of weed. I do not know why I'm this much higher than normal.
Don't worry about it. Listen. Spell hippopotamus.
Oh,
shit. He gonna do it.
H I P P O P O T.
Come on, G, because you're the spelling. He's the spelling bee champ over here. This guy, he's still looking.
Either IMUS or OMUS. I can't remember.
We don't need the O or yes, or it has to be or not. This is what we're doing. And or check.
I'm gonna go with I.
Okay, that's what he's gonna go with. He doesn't know. He's so dumb.
I don't know.
What do you mean, hippopotamus? You might get it before you.
P O T I M U S. Is that right? Hippopotamus.
No, he's lying. He has no idea. Bizarre hippopotamus.
Hippopotamus.
What? That's like his opt out button. No,
like technically said like afterwards.
I'm done. I don't want to do this shit.
The best I could.
Hip-hop. That's the safe word. Yeah, that's the safe word. Hip hop. I mean, you ain't got to spell shit. What's happening?
What's happening?
Holy shit.
Now let's talk about Detroit. Give me Detroit's scenery. Not just the music, but how Detroit is today, 2023. How y'all knew it and where is that today? Bring me to Detroit. We in New York. We want to go to Detroit right now. If I came to Detroit, where y'all taking me first?
Coney Island.
No, that's in Brooklyn.
There's a Coney Island
in Detroit?
This is something different. I can't explain. I'm not sure why, though.
Coney Island is basically... They serve like Coney dogs, like chili cheese fries, chili dogs.
Okay. That's a common food.
Isn't like, it like Coney Island?
Yeah, but they
But they also serve breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and they open 24 hours.
But it's a restaurant. Though.
So I just want to know why they want to take us to Coney Island first.
Coney Island is so huge that it's different Coney Islands. Like it might be like 5 mile Coney Island.
Every city has Coney Island.
Okay.
So you'll see Coney Island more than you'll see McDonald's.
But what he did was he explained it to you in actual terms. It's a restaurant that serves this type of food, but it's a Coney Island.
So it's basically like a Waffle.
That's what it's called.
But it's
no,
hell no.
No, listen. No, because they do breakfast too. But literally, the best ones. It's all about how good your hot dogs are. It's all about how good your chili cheese fries are.
Okay.
But I'm saying that they like
you basically can get the same thing you would get at McDonald's at the same price. So people are gonna fuck with Coney before they fuck with McDonald's.
Got it.
Because you can get a big ass cheeseburger, fries
at the same price
for like $6.
Got it.
You know what I'm saying?
I mean, yeah. So they
have.
All right, so we're gonna go there. Then where we going after that?
After we go there, should we hip hop? Probably go to downtown. Go see downtown. Go see Belle Isle. That's the island. Way by road around.
I've been to Detroit one time, and we just was downtown, and that was it. From the airport, downtown. From downtown, airport. Yeah.
That'll probably take you to some of the dispensaries.
Oh yeah, you said y'all got wild dispensaries.
Yeah, yeah,
everywhere.
There's a cookies.
Especially
out
where
there.
I'm at.
Yeah, cookies. Yes. Yeah.
Now speaking of that, because I know my boy a connoisseur, because he just said he smokes a lot of weed. Give me your favorite strain.
Okay.
I was about to say you have one.
I don't have new ones.
No, but you know your go-to, like me.
No, I don't have a go-to.
I'm a Kush guy. I love Kush.
Can I be honest with you? I'd rather talk about like 10, 12 years ago when I that lemon haze that was out back then.
Haze in New York.
I'm comparing eras and like how good, like how much I love the way that shit smelled back when weed was the way it was then.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That was like my favorite. Instead of talking about what I'm going to now, because I really don't give a fuck. As long as the percentage is high on it, I don't care.
When's the first time you started smoking?
The first time I ever smoked weed, I was 11. And I remember my brother's boy passed me the joint, and they were all downstairs smoking, and he was like, inhale it. I hit it.
Hit your chest.
And I heard, I don't remember who said it, but one of them cats goes, swallow it. And I swallowed the smoke.
No pause.
Listen. So I swallowed smoke, and like 5 seconds went by, and I was like, it disappeared. And right when I said it, it just went boof and piled out of my face. But for whatever reason, I did not get high.
Oh, shit.
I didn't get high for like my next 10 or 12 times. I kept doing it, and I didn't get it. I was in 8th grade, and every time I go out to my homie's house, we'd be smoking weed. I swear to God. But that happens with people where they don't get high the first few times. For whatever reason, it took... I can't explain to you how it was like even possible.
I didn't get high the first 10 times I smoked weed. I seen my body leave. I watched my soul go into the sky the first time. That's I'm still looking crazy. For that high. That was the best high ever. Clean and gone. When I say gone, and I don't fuck with edibles. Y'all fuck with edibles? Who fucked with edibles?
I can't do edibles. Edibles make you trip out, man.
Yeah. He loves them shits. It's a roller coaster. You're on until the bitch stops. I can't do it. I can't do it. There's no point. Look, when you're getting high, you can just clip the bitch and put it down and you're good. Get your little high and fly it out. No. Him?
Tell them why you don't fuck with edibles. Because you're
the professor.
You ate a whole fucking brownie like it was a snack with milk, like the you was having a nighttime snack. Like, who does that?
The professor
a
said.
A whole brownie.
Again, I almost died.
I had the same problem with a whole brownie.
Y'all, oh, shit.
It was a flight back from Vegas, and my homie warned me.
Oh, this is crazy. When the first time you started smoking, Bizarre?
I think 18.
What was that experience like?
Shit, it was cool because it was, I think it was a hot box.
First
time?
Yeah.
That's like getting a tattoo. You got to get a big tattoo first because you can't, like, what the fuck? He dove
hot
in.
Hot box was like, when it hit, you might as well just say, I'm here and it's over.
So would y'all feel, would y'all say it's medicinal for y'all or it's more recreational? Just,
I would say it's addiction. I just do it every single day.
You're just addicted to it. Yeah, I think you don't smoke for no purpose.
I think people like take like laws. Like when things start going good, they take that shit like to the limits. Yeah. So like people don't recognize it as like an addiction no more. They're like, dude, it's legal now, man. You're allowed to just fucking be high all the time.
It's like a cigarette.
But at the end of the day, man, you're just staying cooked all day, man.
Why some people can work off of it, and some people can't.
See, I think most people can't. Yeah. I think they lie about it.
Once I get to a certain level, it's the bun, 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 bun.
Yeah, exactly. I remember people in high school, but man, I get higher scores on tests.
Nah,
who the fuck gets a higher score on a test when you're 16 years old, cooked? Nobody does. That's a lie.
They was telling me before you came back, because I was like, they can carry weed on a plane and all that.
Where?
In Detroit. We're in Detroit.
Huh. Ain't gonna catch me with that. Ain't gonna get me deported.
Oh, no, we're saying way, yeah. We won't touch it.
Not from, not New York, but in Detroit. It's
oh, shit. I'm still scared of it. I won't do it.
I didn't know that.
When I get to the town, who got some weed?
That's how it always is.
Fuck that. You got to tap in with whoever you know, and they got it, you know, same way when they come, you got them, they got you when you get there. But bring it.
Yeah. It's just crazy to think that you really won't get in trouble, though. I'm still scared of taking the risk, you know what I'm saying, even though you're allowed to.
Nah, yeah, people still come to New York and ask certain things. Can we do this? Can we do this?
Oh,
is it all right for me to like this? And I'm like,
we was in front
legal.
Of the precinct. Two cops was right there.
Factual.
Shit felt so good.
But y'all got to watch
out.
A few
years ago, you'd have been ducking around cars and running.
But make sure y'all smoking that good stuff, because they lacing all this weed now with fentanyl. All that fentanyl.
Weed?
I know y'all know about that. They lacing that. They catching
what
all these they catching all these dispensaries selling all this fentanyl laced weed. So
that's crazy.
Be careful what y'all smoke. Be careful what y'all smoke, man. Be careful what y'all smoke.
Can't just take a blunt from anybody nowadays.
I can't believe we're saying all that.
But you should be able to believe that you can
smoke some shit like that. Oh, the weed's gonna be legal in 20 years. But some shit they lace with coke, they're gonna stick it in a weed. None of that makes any sense.
Just think about the person that's in jail right now that got caught 20 years ago for weed.
Yeah.
Yo, Bizarre is done.
Nah, he's gone.
He's high. Yo, he's looking at us like, yo, man, shut the fuck up already. Come on, man, cut this fucking camera off. Sweet Leaf's got me. Go.
He's out of here.
So,
all right, so let's
help him out.
Yeah,
let's
wrap up the album. Where can they find it? Where can they stream it?
It's coming out June.
When is it? Give me the date.
June 9th.
Where can they find it? Everywhere?
Every place you can go to get it.
Okay.
Every single one. But just be real, we're all doing the same shit.
Everybody. You ain't lying.
I love
you.
If you want, you can just look it up.
There you go.
Everywhere.
There you go.
Except you can just find out our pages. Yeah. Obviously, we'll be promoting it.
So give them a little look. Give them all your social media.
I love it.
I love this more. Give me social media.
Foulmouth 313, Instagram, Twitter.
Spell it for them.
Facebook, Napster.
Spell Foulmouth. Spell how you got
it. F-O-U-L. M-O-U-T-H.
Say one more time.
F-O-U-L-M-O-U-T-H.
Okay.
And he meant it.
Yeah.
He definitely meant it.
He definitely meant it.
He said Napster. They're like this right now. Oh, thank you. We've been folded, but thank you.
Yo.
Bizarre. You just want us to add your social media.
He not spelling shit. He not spelling shit. Fuck that. He not spelling nothing.
Nah, let's give him a
but,
chance. I think he can.
Give
me social media. He can do it. Come on. Here we go. It's coming. It's coming. Here we go.
What was that? He was trying to get feeling back in his hand.
He's thinking about it. It's coming.
Yo.
He became a villain. You want me to spell your name?
He's
scheming.
This
shit.
Yo.
Biggie still hasn't done it. Here we go.
I can't do it. I might leave before the camera goes.
Come on.
This. Shout out to the sponsors.
Yo,
what the fuck
drop.
Is happening?
He has
to
do
the drop.
Sweet Leaf's got him gone.
He
got to
do the drop. Come on.
These are.
What? What?
Yeah. That was
drunk. Spell that.
He became French. He said, Bizarre.
What?
Bizarre.
Y'all know him. Legendary.
Bizarre.
And this moment is just as legendary as him.
Wow.
Yo, look, man.
And on that note.
Thank you for coming out. God bless you. And good night.
Good night.
Oh,
it's a bomb threat. You ain't bomb yet. Brand new gun. Check out this bomb tech. Small dog. White neighbor. Star Wars. Lifesaver. Watch this life shaker. Life cold. Ice maker. School dance. Icebreaker. Watch this knife shaker. Bizarro G. Nice flavor. Good weed. No seed. Rice paper. I'm a nigga you wanna stay away from. You ain't got no dick like Dwayne Wade, son. Nigga, I just cop 600 Beezys. Black and white, just cop 600 Yeezys. All in Chicago, just fuck 600 Breezys. Detroit niggas, y'all sound like 600 Beezys. Bitch, this house a mess. I'm on house arrest. 2 plus 2, let's see who can count the best. This ounce of stress. This is foul mouth mixed with alchemist. Bitch, you been sucking dick all night. Give your mouth a rest. This sick shit is monumental. Eat this breakfast, it's a continental. Mushroom tea, blown on the holy day. Skinny joint, skinny than Coley Ray. And fuck a drive-by, I get out and blast. Hit his door and dash. Fuck a tip, I'm on your ass. Yeah, pistol packing, I'm tearing shit. Yeah, dunk down, I'm airing shit. Yeah. I'm an outlaw, I'm an outlaw. This 4-5, I tell your motherfucking jaw off. Pistol packing, I'm airing shit. Yeah, duck down, I'm tearing shit. Yeah, I'm an outlaw, I'm an outlaw. This 4-5, I tell your motherfucking jaw off. My new girlfriend, a toxic bitch. Bitch, open this door, take this toxic dick. I hit niggas up, show them what a spittle whack. I rock and roll old niggas, hit him with the nickel back.
It's a bomb!
Nah, it's a fucking earthquake. Rod Stevens, get him on the first take. You ain't harming that, you ain't bombing that. I wash niggas up, I should work for a laundromat. I want my respect, I'm hiding the jet. They should call me the police, cause I be on niggas next. Real talk. Nigga, fuck your homie. I love Jalen Rose, but I robbed Jacoby. I'm a hot nigga. Bitch, this is hell day. Nasty nigga. Ass smell like Del Rey.
He got a gun, motherfucker.
Yeah, pistol packing, I'm tearing shit. Yeah. Duck down, I'm airing shit. Yeah. I'm a outlaw. I'm a outlaw. This 4-5, I tear your motherfucking jaw off. Pistol packing, I'm airing shit. Yeah. Duck down, I'm tearing shit. Yeah. I'm a outlaw. I'm a outlaw. This 4-5, I tear your motherfucking jaw off.
I'm like, ready to, that's a 9-hour flight. No weed, you can't smoke. I told you, I didn't even, man, look. All right, man. I'll be ready. Yeah, I'll be ready.
This is Delta Airlines. Damn, this flight will be taking off from Atlanta, Georgia to Dublin, Ireland for 7.5 hours.
This flight for 7 hours. Can't smoke no fucking sour.
Damn.
I think I need a shower.
Yeah.
I think I need some powder. It's a long flight. I can't hit the pipe. I'm up all night trying to take a flight. I'm going off the perkies. All up early, it's damn near 7:30.
I wish I was high, high, high. I wish I was high, high. I wish I was high, high, high. I wish I was high.
Be stuck in the matrix, higher than a spaceship. I be smoking big blunts, I be smoking hella blunts. I'm gonna fade away.
Fade away. Now I'm faded. Sipping on some. Now I made it. Now I'm hot. Got it going. 20 shots. Now they smoking. Smoking drugs. Got me smoking drugs. Blowing bud, getting fucked up in the club. Rolling sweets, getting super geek. Got a friend, and you know I'm about to be.
I wish I was high, high.
ain't high. I wish I was high. High. I wish I was high. 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 I wish I was high.